We want to figure out what the sum of all of the numbers that are entered is, and also what the count is, so we can use them to calculate the average and return it. We can use a do loop to collect the user input. Somewhere in the do loop, we'll have to update value by getting the next user input. So we'll need to ask the user for a double, and then read in the next double using the scanner. If the value is 0, then we want to quit. But if it's not, we want to increment count and add to the sum. So count goes up, and sum goes up. So how long do we want to keep going? We want to keep going as long as value is not 0. Because if value is 0, that means we read a 0 from the user. So we continue doing these steps as long as value is not 0. Let's try this after I fix up my syntax errors. Running the main method. If I enter 2, it doesn't quit. Negative 3, doesn't quit. 0, it stops, and it gives me an average. Let's look at the program again, though. There's some repetition here. We have to check that the value is not equal to 0 in two different places. We could change this. So instead of using a do while loop, it would just use a while loop and only check the value is not equal to 0 in one place. We would declare a Boolean to track whether we're done or not yet. Initially, we're not done, so it starts as false. Then, as long as we're not done, we would keep doing the things in the loop, so we wouldn't need the while at the bottom. As is, this loop would go forever, because we never change the value of done. So when do we want to say that we're done? Well, we want to say that we're done if somebody puts in a 0. So if the value is 0, then we set done to true. This will work the same way. When I run the main method, it'll ask for doubles until I enter 0, and then give the average. You can structure any loop and a half this way, using a Boolean to guard your condition.